Welcome to part two of the 2018 Trophy Awards. In part one, we as a community came up with the best overall trophy list, so make sure you check out that video and see what your favorite games of the year were. Now part three will be the easiest platinum trophies of the year, so make sure you ring the notification bell so you don't miss that. In this video, I'll give you the 10 hardest platinum trophies of the year. I asked you guys to tell me what the hardest platinum was, and you gave me a solid list of tough games. Now almost certainly there's going to be some obscure games that a few people have ever heard of that won't make this list. I found the most difficult part of this being where to rank these titles. You could probably make a case for each of these to be number one. They all share the same ridiculous low percentage of achievers, and many will take hundreds of hours. Many also will include a high level of player skill, and because everyone's skill level is different, we will have a different opinion on which game was actually the hardest. So let's just jump right into this thing, starting with number 10. PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds, or PUBG, is the game that popularized the Battle Royale mode when it launched over a year and a half ago on PC. It only just landed on PS4 this month, so very few people have earned the platinum. The game features a very basic trophy list. For the most part, you'll just need to get a certain number of kills in various different ways, so there's going to be quite a bit of a grind. The longest grind will be to get 1,000 kills. If you're averaging 3 kills per game, that's over 300 games you'll play. It wouldn't be a Battle Royale game if you also didn't have to earn some chicken dinners along the way. You'll only have to win one solo, one duos, and one squad game, but you'll need a total of 10 victories between those modes. It has the lowest percentage of platinum earners in this entire list, but that number will dramatically increase as more people put in more time into this new release. Number 9 is Kingdom Come Deliverance. The difficulty of this game is making sure you don't miss out on any of the 12 missable trophies, something you don't want to do in a game that has a 50-hour story. Thankfully, for most of those, if you fail to earn one of the trophies during a quest, you could just reload your autosave to replay that quest. However, there are a few missable trophies that require you to do certain things across the entire playthrough. One of those is for beating the game without killing anyone, another for remaining a virgin, and finally, another for being popular in every town and village. The game itself can be difficult during the early parts of it, but you'll be spending a lot of time grinding out the skills and money to get the platinum trophy. Number 8 is Dissidia Final Fantasy NT. This Square Enix RPG will ask you to devote between 200 to 300 hours to earn its platinum. It does have a very time-consuming trophy which requires you to get 300 treasures. You'll basically have to reach level 241 to earn that trophy. Doing that and completing all the other story-related trophies will leave you with the online ranked matches. Of course, you'll need to win 300 ranked matches in the online mode. There are also 28 trophies, one for each character, that may or may not be difficult. Earning these legitimately is a very time-consuming test of skill, where you'll need to get a grade of A++ 3 times with each of the 28 characters. This requires you to win and score over 1900 points in each match. However, there is an easier method, an exploit of sorts, that makes this much more manageable. This exploit requires you to go into your PS4's network settings and change one of the settings there. This can make the game fail to matchmake you with another human and will instead put you up against a bot. Depending if you use the exploit or not, the game is either going to be a 4 or 10 difficulty. Number 7 is FIFA 19, and it's a very skill-dependent platinum. Literally, the most rare trophy is for getting a grade of A on all the skill games, for which there are over 60. Many are relatively simple, but there are more than a few that are very difficult. Thankfully, you can cheese some of those by editing your player to have 99 stats across the board and change a rival's goalkeeper to 1 for some of the harder ones. Now, one of the really frustrating trophies will be climbing the ladder to reach Division 4 in the Ultimate Team Rivals. This is an online trophy where you'll gain points for winning, but if you don't win, you'll lose points. You'll also need to reach 1600 points, and it'll be a grind to reach it, or impossible if you aren't skilled enough. Depending on your opponent's skill level, it's possible to lose more points than you would have won as you advance. As you progress, you'll face more skilled players, or a player with a team that is far better than yours, or possibly a combination of both. Number 6 is Red Dead Redemption 2. I understand that this rank will be controversial. I asked you guys to give me the hardest platinum trophy, and nearly half of you pointed to Red Dead 2, the other half to another game we'll get to later on, so I suspect many people thought this would have been number 1. The truth is, the individual tasks in this game aren't necessarily hard, but there are so many of them that it'll take well over 200 hours to complete this. Getting the best in the West trophy for 100% completion, and then studying all 178 animals for the zoologist trophy are just two of the more grindy trophies. You'll also need to grind a whole bunch of money to purchase ridiculously high cost camp upgrades, for which you'll need 5, and you'll spend what feels like forever looking for perfect pelts, and then you'll need to earn 70 gold medals in story missions, which is probably the most difficult trophy in this list. Thankfully, there are 104 story missions, so you can skip some of the more difficult ones. Reaching level 50 online will also take you a long time. Now, the good thing is that the game is a lot of fun and really good if you can overlook some of the tedious parts of it. Number 5 is NBA 2K19. Now, last year, I proclaimed that I wouldn't feature this franchise in my year-end list anymore, but many people always vote for this game, so I'm going to just do it for you guys. The trophy list really irritates me because they make it intentionally difficult and encourages predatory microtransaction purchases. Now, the game always launches without certain player cards, making the platinum unattainable at launch. You can platinum it now, but it's still exceptionally hard. My feelings about the franchise aside, the hardest trophy is called Perfection. You'll have to win 10 games in a row online. Being great at this game isn't good enough. So let's move on. Number 4 is Beat Saber. This is the first time I've included a PSVR-only title in the Trophy Awards, and I've included it because it's probably the best PSVR-only title, and it's generated a ton of buzz because of it. This is a game where you'll need to be in decent shape, physical shape, and if you aren't, well, you'll get in shape while playing this. Beat Saber is a rhythm game that scores you based on your accuracy of your saber hits along with your combo. What makes this game exceptionally difficult is that you need to get an S ranking on 15 levels on expert difficulty, as well as full combos on 15 expert levels. The game ships with 16 levels or songs, although more have been and will hopefully continue to be added through DLC, and maybe some of those will make the platinum a little easier. Similar in nature as the old Guitar Hero games, you will need to develop insane skills to platinum this. To make things worse, getting S ranks has actually now become harder recently because they've removed the bug that allowed players to get an S rank when they slow down songs and remove obstacles. Number 3 is Dragon Ball FighterZ. Fighting games like this are almost always a guarantee to make it on any list of difficult platinums. This makes it because of one difficult and one really grindy trophy. The one that requires a lot of skill requires you to earn 530,000 BP. I'm assuming that means battle points. You'll probably encounter more than a few players pulling their internet connection when you're about to win, which makes this very frustrating. This is an online ranked mode where you will gain or lose points depending on who wins. You'll eventually reach a point where you'll find yourself fighting some of the best players. You'll need to be incredibly skilled at this game to earn this trophy unless you boost it with a friend. It's possible to match up with a partner and trade wins if you're patient enough. Dragon Ball FighterZ also has a terribly grindy trophy called Set for Life. You'll need to acquire 20 million Zenny, which is the currency in the game. You'll devote 50 hours of mindless grinding for just this one trophy. 50 hours for one trophy. But since this game can be both boosted and mindlessly grinded, it's only number 3 on this list. Number 2 is Call of Duty Black Ops 4. Once again, the Call of Duty franchise has posted a difficult trophy list, but this time around, it's mostly online trophies. The trophy list is divided among the 4 various modes: traditional multiplayer, zombies, the specialist HQ mode, and of course the new Blackout Battle Royale mode. Your first real challenge will be within the zombies mode. Across the zombie maps, you'll have to complete the complex Easter eggs along with some various miscellaneous trophies for all of them along the way. Then you can move on to obtain max level with 25 different weapons in zombies. The most difficult trophies aren't even in zombies, they're in Blackout. This Battle Royale mode will require 10 wins, not too hard since you can get in a good squad if you're unable to do it solo. Unlocking the characters is what will be your biggest concern. Recently though, Treyarch has made this much easier for us as they unlocked all 10 specialist characters giving everyone that trophy for free, but you still have to unlock the zombies and the iconic characters. These require you to find an item, some exceptionally rare and many in random locations, and then to go on and complete various requirements. For example, to unlock the Reznov character, you will need to find a rare hat, get a kill over 200 meters, and then finish in the top 5 in solo or top 3 in duos, top 2 in squads. Some of the items are so rare that you may play 100 games and not even find one to start the little quest. Having said all that, character quest drop rates and requirements may change over time, making this easier at a later date, or Treyarch may just give them to us like they did with the specialists. At this time, Black Ops 4 might not have the hardest individual trophies, but it certainly has the highest number of very hard ones. Number one goes to Tetris Effect. This is a game that you can play with or without PSVR, although many will say they like it in VR better. Tetris has always been a highly skillful game, and the trophy list will require a lot of skill, and you'll have to play this for a long time to reach player level 100 or to spin the blocks over a million times. The platinum blocker in this, however, is for earning an SS rank on all of the modes. These are incredibly difficult to achieve, and even if you think you are fast, you'll be far too slow. In sprint mode, you will need to clear 40 lines in a minute and 10 seconds. You'll have to get 55,000 points in countdown, a mode that has some RNG along with many other crazy requirements across its many modes. Now, obviously, Tetris is a game where the more you play, the better you'll be, just like every other game. But this game, more than others, will require you to really become a master at the game. So that'll do it for this video. Let me know in the comments if you platinum any of these, or if you, like myself, haven't platinum any of them. Make sure you ring that notification bell for the final part while I'll peek in at the easiest platinum trophies of 2018.